In a few minutes, when this vote closes, we're going to go upstairs and hold a moment of silence for the victims of yesterday's shooting. We've lowered the flags here in the Capitol to half-staff. Our first thoughts are with the families of those who are lost. We know at least 5 people right now are fighting for their lives, and we need to pray for each one of those people who are fighting for their lives right now. We also just thank God for law enforcement and for the heroes at the school. I just want to offer this. There are a lot of worries that come with being a parent of teenagers. We've got 3 of them. But this is the nightmare. This is pure evil. For these kids, yesterday should have just been typical high school day. In an instant, this became the worst day of their lives. You know, I was just looking at this morning. I go back to this message that one of the students sent to her mom. She said, "If I don't make it, I love you, and I appreciate everything you did for me." I mean, all that fear, that terror, for her to think of love and even gratitude for her parents. We can learn a lot from our kids. This is one of those moments where we just need to step back and count our blessings. We need to think less about taking sides and fighting each other politically and just pulling together. This house and the whole country stands with the Parkland community. I'm going to take some questions, but we started late here. I'm going to be a little brief because I got to get upstairs to the chair. So, Chad.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. When you talk about not taking sides, the minority leader just stood here a few moments ago and was critical of their demands, their request to have a select committee on gun violence, action on background checks, criticized your leadership for saying the response to their sit-in in 2016 was to investigate who was periscoping. What do you, is that the taking of sides that you're referring to?
As you know, mental health is often a big problem underlying these tragedies. That may be the case here today based on early reporting. We passed legislation on mental health. We want to make sure that if someone's in the mental health system that they don't get a gun if they're not supposed to get a gun. We will find out as facts come out whether there was a breakdown in the system or not here today. As you also know, we passed legislation cleaning up the instant check background check system. That bill, with others, is sitting over in the United States Senate. So if there's someone who's not supposed to get a gun who's getting a gun, then we got to figure out why that's happening and fix that. That's a piece of legislation we already passed that's sitting in the Senate. And what one thing we know is if there are early indications for mental illness, I think we probably have to do a better job of trying to make sure that people don't get slipped through the cracks.
Mr. Speaker, should law enforcement be able to confiscate a weapon from someone who has exhibited signs of mental illness?
Like I said before, this is not the time to jump to some conclusion not knowing the full facts. We've got a lot of more information we need to know. But if someone who is mentally ill is sleeping through the cracks and getting a gun, because we have laws on the books. We have a system to prevent people who aren't supposed to get guns from getting guns. And if there are gaps there, then we need to look at those gaps. That's like the legislation we passed fixing the NICS system.
Yes, Mr. Speaker, why won't you support or allow hearings to move forward on background checks? What is your resistance to that?
The fixed NICS bill, which is part of our broader bill, does fix the background check system. Remember the shooting in Texas. There was a man who had been convicted in the Air Force of domestic violence. He wasn't supposed to get a gun, yet the Air Force didn't give the records to the instant check system, and he got a gun. That's one of the reasons why we passed legislation plugging that loophole, making sure that was the case. So that came from hearings. We had hearings on the gaps in the instant check system, and those hearings led to a conclusion that there were gaps that need to be fixed. And that led to legislation that has been now passed the House.
Mr. Speaker, Lisa from PBS. The question I think is, so you're saying that obviously we need to look into if there's gaps. The Attorney General this morning also said if there's problems, we've got to address it. Something is not right. There's something we've got to fix. Would you consider a select committee, whatever you call it,
on
this issue?
I think Congress should do its job, and that's what we passed mental health legislation 2 years ago because of the underlying mental health problems that were behind these shootings. That legislation is now just taking place. That legislation is now being implemented. We, from early reportings, understand that there may be some mental health issues with this shooting. So the question is, are those laws where they need to be? Is it being implemented properly? Are they being enforced correctly? Remember, we do have laws on the books designed to prevent people with mental illnesses from getting firearms, to design people who have criminal backgrounds from getting firearms. The question is, just like the Texas instance, are those laws working the right way? Are there loopholes that needed to be plugged? We found some loopholes that needed to be plugged, and we passed a bill to plug those loopholes.
Last question.
Andy.
Would you consider moving this Fix Nix legislation as a standalone bill, or
our bills,
consider insisting on these provisions that were sought by the National Rifle Association?
Our bill is in the Senate. Hopefully the Senate can pass something, then we'll meet them in conference like the regular legislative process.
But you understand there's some provisions there. What is it, concealed carry?
I think that's a good self-defense bill. So that's something that's in the Senate. We'll see if the Senate can get to conference, and then we can figure out what we can do from there.
Mr. Speaker,